Good afternoon, everybody. Hidden in plain sight, on a hill right next to the 15, right here in Escondido, is probably the world's most efficient farm. If you pop into the greenhouses, you'll find vegetables densely planted on rafts floating in water in what looks like a hydroponic system. But a hydroponic system is growing plants without soil and using chemical fertilizers. This system is different. We're depending on fish for our fertilizer, a nice organic enriched fertilizer, and to make that easy, we've connected our hydroponics right to an aquaculture system or fish farming system. Together, aquaculture and hydroponics form aquaponics and a revolution in the way we grow protein and produce. And I'm not even done. Now you might ask why we need a revolution in how we produce our food, and here's the answer. Agriculture today is the leading cause of extinction. The earth is in the middle of a spasm of extinction like it's never seen before since life on this planet. The majority of those extinctions are directly tied to agriculture. And that's because in this spasm of extinction, animals are going extinct because of habitat loss. And agriculture is the leading cause of habitat loss and climate change in the world. It's converting our habitats from rich forests, grasslands, scrublands, into agricultural lands. At the same time, it's a primary driver of climate change, and that climate alters even more habitats, leading to more problems for us. On top of all of this, agriculture consumes more fresh water than any other activity that human beings do. But the important part is that we really need it. We are dependent entirely on agriculture for our survival. We have to do better, and we can do better. So let me try to bring this story just a little bit closer to home for you. Here in the state of California, with our friends in Arizona, we grow 70% of the lettuce that's consumed in the United States. In fact, California grows more lettuce than any country in the world, with the exception of China. This has an enormous impact on each and every one of us. First and foremost, every day, you are reaping the financial benefits of a healthy agricultural system in our state. But at the same time, we're also dealing with the environmental consequences and costs of that agriculture. In the state of California, to grow one head of lettuce requires about 9 gallons of water. I don't want to bury you in dizzying figures, but let me tell you that what that means is that every year, the state of California exports 34 billion gallons of water out of the state. That's a state that went dry more than 100 years ago. Now, don't get me wrong, this isn't a ban on agriculture. My wife and I love to garden. There's nothing better than turning rich soil in your backyard, being able to walk through in the late afternoon and pick warm tomatoes and food for your dinner. But myself, along with many others who are brighter thinkers than I am, have come to realize with 8 billion people on the planet and more coming, we need to find more efficient ways to feed ourselves. And that brings us back to the story of aquaponics. So let me tell you how it works. Before I get into the depths of it, I want you to take one thing. I know this is the only thing that you'll remember from today, and that is fish don't pee. Hang on to that. They still need to get rid of their nitrogen waste, though, and they do that by releasing it in the form of ammonia from their gills. If you went to a pet store and bought a bowl of fish and took it home, the instructions were really simple. 2 pinches of food morning and night. Once a week, dump out half the water and put in fresh water. What you're doing is replacing the ammonia-laden water with clean water so that you don't poison your fish. In an aquaponics system, we don't look at that ammonia as poison. We look at it as the next stage in fertilizer. So that ammonia-rich water is taken away from the fish, run through biofilters, where naturally occurring microorganisms digest the ammonia first into nitrites and then into nitrates. Nitrates are the form of nitrogen that is most available to plants. If you go to the store and buy a bag of fertilizer, first thing on there is nitrogen. That's the most important part of it. So we take this nitrogen-rich water now that the bacteria have digested so beautifully for us, and we run it past the plants. This rich water, heavy with fertilizer, allows these plants to grow 25% faster than they would in the ground, simply because there's no competition for the nutrition. Once they've taken all the nitrates out of the water, we now can send clean water back to the fish. This is a natural and remarkable cycle that saves land and saves water. This greenhouse in 900 square feet in 1 year will produce 2.5 tons of produce. It'll produce enough tilapia for you to have more fish taco Tuesdays than you can imagine. And it does all that very economically. The plants that we grow in this system are grown using 90% less water than traditional agriculture and on 10% of the land. The fish in this system are grown with 1% of the water used in commercial aquaculture systems. This is really an amazing system, and it's not new. This is how the world has worked for a very, very long time. And it's not new to farming either. Almost 2,000 years ago, the Thai people started using aquaponics, and later the Aztecs here in Central America. The trick is, how do we bring this technology now into the new world of agriculture that we have here? It's certainly not our intent to put any of our farmers out of business, and I don't think it's likely that we would do so. But in order to spread this message around, we need to be able to search for opportunities, places where there's holes in our systems that we can fill and where we can do better and demonstrate how agriculture can be done properly. This means bringing it to small communities, to school cafeterias, to community gardens, and in fact to remote villages all around the world where slash and burn agriculture still occurs, destroying acres and acres of rainforest every single day. In order to get into these communities, we needed to find a way to do it, and I would like to introduce the MARC, the Mobile Aquaponics Response Kit. In a 20-foot container, jam-packed to the hilt, is all the equipment you need to drop that container off literally anywhere, on a rock, in a desert, in a rainforest, in your backyard. And in about 24 hours, set up a farm that in 3 months will provide you with 3,500 heads of lettuce or whatever other vegetables you might want to grow, and you can start having your fish taco Tuesdays. In any event, a long time ago, someone said, whiskey's for drinking, water's for fighting. And today, those words ring very true. We're battling for the survival of our coastal deltas, for the survival of our commercial fisheries, to have water in our homes and for our landscape, for recreation, and yes, a huge amount of water to keep our agricultural industry moving forward. So it's time for us to start a fight where everybody wins. And the secret to doing this is hidden no more right here in the community of Escondido. Thank you.